Alright, so, tournaments. You heard of them? About half a year ago, I know, I'm lazy, I entered the first official Malaysian OSU Mania tournament, hosted by Cryo and Unicow. Having not played in an OSU tournament for years, I decided it'll be a good experience competing, as well as good content, hey. Well, the most recent tournament I had played in prior to this was the first Quaver tournament, and, well...
It's probably going to be going over to Kibitz here.
And a fourth one, yeah, it ain't looking good. The accuracy still looks extremely solid, but meanwhile, Kibitz, on the other hand, about to go on the path towards an FC.
And yeah, a pretty flawless performance there.
I mean, I mean, given it's 3,500 notes, I assume there is one. Or two.
Yeah, good performance from both players, just unfortunately lovely stamina dropping it. That's a PFC!
Run. Oh my god.
That's impressive.
Yeah, I kind of smashed it. So, in this video, I'll be going over my experience in playing in the tournament, as well as giving you my insight going into the matches, so that for those who watch this, you too will be inspired to participate in future tournaments too. Oh, and also, if you like my content, consider hitting that subscribe button. It really helps me out. Also, come over to the Twitch channel, where I stream my practice and, who knows, maybe you'll catch me playing in a tournament. Thanks. Enjoy. Before we get started, with every OSU tournament, it all begins with the qualifier maps. If you are new to OSU Mania tournaments, the qualifier stage consists of pretty much 4 maps or more, depending on what tournament you're in, highlighting different skill sets. Usually these maps consist of SV, which are memory-based maps with timing changes to slow and speed up the song.
In the second part with all the SVs, it is similar to the first section, but... yeah, the difficulty in the stutter streams is heavily ramped. So the ending part here, it will kill your accuracy a little bit.
Accuracy slash tech maps, which test your timing and ratio with complex patterns.
Alright, yeah, here, this part right here. The grace note that you can somewhat play as a jump drill. But obviously,
yep.
Minisora,
as I said earlier,
making it not look hard at all.
The LN release map, which challenges your long note ability and release timings, especially with the Score V2 mod being active during the match.
Growing timing, dude. Yeah, back up to the map.
Yeah, this part here, it picks up a little. You can see a lot of some finger control happening and also some shields. Yeah.
And last but not least, the speed stream maps, which test your stamina with variety of stream patterns which can trip you up very easily.
Yeah, it's the speed and density that's where the real difficulty is, so... I can see quite a bit of the higher tier players, not gonna say who, but you should know yourself. You will also somewhat still struggle on this.
Oh, I forgot. We also had a hybrid map, which pretty much merges rice and long nets together into one map.
Wait, technically this is actually an LN focus hybrid. Based on the notes.
Because in terms of rise difficulty, although the rise it is there, we can see a little bit of a jump stream later on. But yeah, it's definitely not as hard as like what you saw in stage 4.
Sadly, I forgot to save the VOD from the qualifier stage, so here's the final standings of the qualifiers.
Okay, so the remaining 4 are the top seeds, which will... the automatic advance.
So, since I finished in second place overall, I automatically advanced to the round of 16 through the winner's bracket, meaning I didn't need to play in the round of 32 with the risk of being eliminated from the tournament. Go me. Alright, here we go. The tournament starts now. So, going into this matchup, I wasn't too worried as I knew my opponent's strength and weaknesses, so I was pretty confident in full comboing every map in the pool.
That would be the first key I...
Oh! Kibitz! Kibitz gets a miss!
Oh. No. Not like this.
And now the score is flickering. VernonLim needs to hold. This is his chance.
Hold. The lead is now in Kibi's hands. That'll be the last key eye, and we're approaching the end of the map.
Yes, we're approaching the end of the map now.
Cool. And that was a chance.
Wow. Yeah. Kibitz gets 990.
With a miss. With a miss.
On V2. What?
Okay, man.
And yeah, pretty much in the lead now, around 70,000 points. This is massive lead here. VernonLim
consistently dropping.
Yeah, this pattern's being too difficult for him to handle. And Kibitz, on the other hand, is gonna close his town in 99.4.
Sight read. Okay. Guys, this is what you should get when you sight read, yes?
V1SS by Kibitz, showing why he's one of the best Malaysian players out there.
But in all honesty, I still have so much respect for VernonLim, because if you didn't know, he's proven himself to be such an insane accuracy player that, I don't know, I might even lose to him next tournament, who knows. So, advancing into the quarterfinals, here we are. One of the most intense matches I've ever played in a tournament. Prior to this match, I had no idea who Ju1nY was, nor have I heard any information of his strengths or weaknesses. The only information I had to work with was his round of 16 match against Stygix. And, well...
Stygix and another one.
Yeah, there needs to be some internal self-destruction for Ju1nY to lose this now. This is out of Stygix's hands. And Ju1nY just needs to see out this ending.
It seems like Ju1nY's not going to miss at all.
Yep, that's a very crazy score. 997.
997?
How many 300s? 89? Okay, so...
His accuracy was fucking nuts. Keeping that in mind, I decided to switch up my strategy going into the match. Oh, and one more thing I didn't mention earlier. After both players play their warm-ups, the players are to do a roll, and the person who rolls the highest gets to choose whether or not to pick a map or ban a map first. Meaning, if I was able to roll higher, I get to see what my opponent will ban, allowing me to see what type of maps they are uncomfortable with playing, as well as getting the advantage to choose the first map that I'm most confident in winning. So, about the new strategy.
We'll struggle quite a lot on that match, so that is a very good ban. And Kibitz
has banned SV2.
Yes. Let's get another predictable ban.
Ban against Ju1nY. And Kibitz has picked SV1. Ju1nY's trying to climb back up to 99% accuracy, but Kibitz is just way too far ahead.
Yeah, this part there's a shift in the patterning. Oh, Kibitz gets a 200 from that. But his accuracy is still quite high compared to Ju1nY.
And there we go.
Yeah.
Kibi's gonna take the first round.
So with that first point under my belt, I assumed Ju1nY was gonna try and counter me with what he does best, accuracy. And boy, let me tell you, I was nowhere near ready for how close this next song was gonna be.
And what is this? They are still holding on. They're still equal.
And now it's actually equal, having the same accuracy, they both need to hold on. This jack goes all the way to the end of the map.
What in the world? We are already approaching, but they are still closing in. Kibitz finally gaining the 0.01% ACK and then dropping down to the same ACK again.
My god, this is gonna be so close.
Who will win?
And Kibitz takes it.
Winning by 210 points!
Oh my gosh! What? What was that?
No way!
Ah, fuck.
Oh!
Winning that breakpoint was a huge confidence boost. I proceeded with my strategy, as I was sure I would be able to out-accuracy him on LN, allowing me to grab my third point of the match.
And as we are coming to the end of the map, it looks like once again, Kibitz will take yet another point.
Here's where things start going bad, though. Ju1nY picks Rice 1, the consistency accuracy map. These Rice maps in the pool were still FC-able for me, however, the worst thing happened.
And what is the score difference? And Kibitz gets the miss!
That's gonna be huge!
This is exactly what Ju1nY needs. Ju1nY needs to just pull combo now. I don't think there's... Yeah, there's just no way from coming back for Kibitz.
Ju1nY's gonna take this point finally, a first point from Ju1nY. And what a unfortunate break from Kibitz.
Trying not to dwell on that misread, I pick the rice-based hybrid 2. Now remember how earlier I said where things started going bad?
These players here. That's a miss from Kibitz! And Ju1nY tanking a lot of accuracy, and the lead is now flickering back to Kibitz.
That is not a good news at all.
It's Kibitz.
Is there hope? I don't think there is.
I'm playing the map, man.
There is no hope.
Wow.
Kibitz wins by 1,000 points of difference.
Yes, despite the miss, he still takes the...
Now, I'm not really a fan of tech maps in tournaments. They are based on weird patterns and weirdly placed mini-jacks along with a sporadic rhythm song. Sometimes these songs may even be just static, but this time...
But Kibitz now dropping accuracy. Ju1nY needs to hold. He cannot afford 200s. Any misses from any of these players will be huge.
Any miracles? Is Kibitz going to miss at the last part? Or are they both going to take the FC? Kibitz going to take the fifth match, winning this one.
And oh, wow. Kibitz getting 2 200s and Ju1nY only getting 1, but that ratio difference. Congratulations to Kibitz. Now moving on to semifinals.
GG's to Ju1nY. I really did not expect such a close match against this person I've never heard of before, but I can't wait to play against him again. But with that said, let's head on into semifinals. Let's go. Now, I have a history with ZYuan. He's rivaled my accuracy for almost 3 years now and pretty much has always beaten me. His release timing on long note density maps and consistency just prove him to be worthy of making it this far in the tournament. He's more known for his 7 key prowess, however, which gave me a slight bit of hope going into this matchup. I could not lose this match. Why? Well, since this match is in the winner's bracket, meaning none of us has lost a match yet, the loser will drop down into the loser's bracket. Now, what's so bad about the loser's bracket?
This is gonna be a close one.
Even accuracies are swinging back and forth.
They're literally the same. Let's see who comes out on top.
The outro, very cool.
Oh.
But there's no more hard parts left. It's going to be accuracy. Oh. Who's gonna come out on top?
Yo!
It's Neo! Oh my god, the slimmest of margins. That is 15 points of difference. 15!
15 points? That's the closest it's been!
Or actually, it's closing a little bit, but it's too little, too late.
Nah. That's it. That does it. What a close score! Both players FCing the tiebreaker. Oh my god!
Man.
None of us want to face Neo, because that's pretty much suicide. With how difficult the next map pull will be, yeah, that's gonna suck. So with that in the back of my mind, I could not lose this match.
New Windows update is whack? I agree. I can't play standard. Nice! Let's go! That's my first roll I've won. Alright. What is he gonna ban? He's probably gonna ban the rice consistency. The 5-minute map. Oh my god! He banned SV1. I thought he was gonna. Okay, this changes everything. Because I was gonna ban SV1. Okay. Then I'm gonna ban LN1, because that's what he's good at.
Winning the role here was crucial, as I had no idea if ZYuan had practiced the SV map, because. You expect me to do that? But he ended up banning SV1, which was super good for me, because if he had rolled higher, I would have to gamble banning SV1 instead of LN1, leaving him the choice to ban a map that I'm actually good at. But that wasn't the case, we won the roll. Here it was, my first pick. I expected ZYuan to favor the accuracy-based hybrids and long note maps, therefore I went with the Courtjack pick. And, well, this was the closest score I've ever gotten in a tournament, ever. Just watch.
But even then, it's still extremely close. Juan is just 1/200 away from equalizing with Kibitz.
Yep, and now we're in the intense Courtjack section.
Oh, there it is. It is at 200. Out of nowhere.
But Kibitz has a very close lead.
It's a very minuscule lead.
He's got to maintain.
As they're both fighting tooth and nail to get anything. Anything, oh, but...
Overall 1%!
Yeah, it's gonna come down to the ending here. Will anyone miss? No, but it looks like...
Jeez,
Juan
identical.
Might be... Oh my god, this is an intense finish. Oh, that is a brutal ending. 150 and 1/100 against 2/100s and a slightly worse ratio, and apparently it's not enough.
And the
despite
first
the exact
point.
Same act.
First break point for ZYuan.
That really sucked. My whole plan had seemed to backfire. As expected, my opponent went with Hybrid 2, the long note based hybrid map. Now, I was pretty confident I could full combo this map, however, having score V2 on, my accuracy was a different issue. But somehow it seems accuracy wasn't only my issue on this map.
You know, Juan has been holding steady at around 99.1.
But ZYuan is still at the range of 99.2 accuracy.
Yep.
The map is now drawing to a close.
Oh,
and this one's ZYuan.
There we go, looks like Kibitz making it through the hard part of the song. Looking forward to this fairly straightforward finish.
There's a second breakpoint.
Nice! Yes! Okay. Nice. Nice, nice, nice.
1-1. We both took each other's picks, but now it was my turn. Considering he did really badly on that long note map, it would have been wise to continue on the long note maps, right? Well, one thing you should know. It doesn't matter how much you practice the tournament map pull, everything depends on how you do on the match itself. You will have to keep in mind that you won't always PB on a tournament day. So with that in mind, it really wasn't worth risking long notes against him, considering he could have just had an unlucky run on that hybrid map. So I went with my original strategy.
1/3 of the map remaining, both players having 0.01% of accuracy differences. We're about to enter the key. I think something just dropped a little bit there.
Looks like Kibitz is pulling ahead.
Nice. I think that was a win. It was close though. Okay.
Expecting another long note map coming my way, I just hoped that I would be able to hold a full combo and let my ratio take care of itself. Assuming ZYuan just had some bad luck on the previous LN base map, I was going into this expecting to lose and prepping myself for the next pick.
I might lose this one. This is a really good pick by him. I'll try my best though.
Oh, just like that, Kibitz is going to get to a third point.
The last roll, and Kibitz with another FC. Getting to the third point of... I believe that's another break point.
I was up 3-1. All I needed to do was contain myself and stick to my strat. I assumed ZYuan was having a pretty bad accuracy session that day. Don't worry, we all get those. Relatable. And so I went with the rice-based hybrid, hoping to out-accuracy him.
But wow, look at this. They're going down to the last third of the song. No one has an advantage yet.
Once again, both players have almost identical accuracy since the start. We are already approaching at the end of the map.
Please tell me that's enough.
Give it the take it now, but it's gonna come down to these very thin notes.
And there
those
you go.
Very thin notes actually gives Juan a break point over Kibitz.
300 points difference.
Watching this back, even I was on the edge of my seat, dude. Our accuracies were pretty much tied the entire time, but seems like he's found his accuracy again. That's not good. Now, there remains one LN map left. The LN speed pick, which I was expecting him to pick, but he actually went with the tech map. Now, I mentioned before, I wasn't too happy about this pick. It had this really weird song with 116 notes featuring so many goddamn mini jacks, man. But a pick's a pick, and I gotta play.
When it comes to accuracy, this is not that good. But I can try and full combo. Full comboing this long map is all that matters.
They're both so perfectly like similar in skill. They've been playing for 2,500 notes and no one has either made a major mistake or had any sort of a lead. What? This is insanely close.
Enough. Oh, so I see 100.
Yeah, maybe Juan's getting a little bit tired. Starting to drop that consistency a bit. So is Kibitz. Oh, wow. Speaking of dropping consistency, that is a huge miss. It takes nearly 3,000 notes, but Juan has finally cracked first.
FC from Kibitz? I wasn't expecting an FC. Wow. The 4 points for Kibitz.
How does he keep getting away with it? Still quite surprised that I managed to FC that, but anyway, I still was confused why ZYuan didn't pick the last LM map in the pool. He actually seemed to be avoiding it, so let's risk it.
He chose the tech rice map over the long note map, which means he does not want to play long note 2, but he's also good at long note, so is he like trying to trick me? I'm more likely to miss on SV, so I'm gonna go with LN2. I'm gonna risk it. He's been avoiding this one. I don't know why, but let's see. Oh no! It's fine, we'll come back.
The LN map that feels like rice. Oh. Wow, there's a... The first note, a 50 from Kibitz. That's what you get for ghost tapping.
Kibitz actually in the lead, but by the smallest of 300 margins.
I threw that so hard. I threw that so fucking hard, bro. And I still won! Let's go, man! Oh my god, I threw that so hard at the beginning. What the fuck? We're in the lead, we're on match point!
Yeah, don't ghost tap in tournaments. But jokes aside, all the hybrid and longnut maps were done and out, leaving only Rice 1, the marathon map, Rice 2, the speed map, Rice 3, the jumpstream stamina map, and SV. It was my opponent's turn to pick, and he decided to go with SV. And well, this kind of happened.
We're going to the second part of the SV session. You know, both of the handling so far.
Okay, it's actually now flickering. Both players are less than 1,000 points from each other. Kibitz is actually making more mistakes, but Swan has just missed. But Kibitz missed What?
Kibitz missed even more.
What are you doing? He was playing so well.
No! I alt-tab!
He was playing so well! Oh, wow.
No fucking way. I could have won. I fucking alt-tabbed! Oh my god!
Kibitz was doing so well, and then at the very end, just lost a sense of rhythm for about 10 seconds, and that was enough damage to cost him the whole point.
So with that unlucky misplay, this was my last pick of this match. If I win this pick, I win the match as a whole. But if I lose, my opponent gets to pick the map. And depending on who wins, the tiebreaker will decide the winner. With my back against the wall, my only options left were the last three Rice maps.
Wow.
Delta time. Right, that means Rice 3.
This is very, very risky. I've never FC'd this map.
Here we go. We're going to see this section. This final section is going to separate the contenders from the pretender.
Here we go.
The flying colors, too. Oh, Kibitz is missed.
Okay, and Zyuan has to hold! Zyuan has to hold!
Wow! I mean, he's slowing the burn by better accuracy, but it's not enough.
Hold!
That is ridiculous.
Hold. And he got it! Zyuan! Taking it back at the last minute.
You know, you gotta fight very hard for it, and if you make the tiniest of slip-up, your opponent's gonna be ready to exploit it. And Juan got the smallest window to play with, and he's managed to execute it flawlessly.
No, it's actually going to go to tiebreaker.
That miss, it really sucked. But it is what it is. I knew that instant I lost Volcanic, and we were going into tiebreaker no matter what.
And it looks like Juan's going to hold. It looks like we're going to be going to a tiebreaker at this rate.
Tiebreaker?
Yep.
Tiebreaker.
They have survived.
The ship has sailed.
The ship has landed. And there we go. It is officially a tiebreaker.
Tiebreaker.
Now, this was my first ever experience playing a tiebreaker in a tournament setting ever. So you could imagine my nerves going into this final map. But one thing I've learned from the god himself, Asu, is that...
Ready for this one, all right? If you're playing bad, wash your hands or change your shirt. Those are two certified ways for a full reset, a full mental reset.
Let's see, we got some short L length from the start here. Both players are literally tied.
Oh, wow. They're actually sharing a very similar
Yeah, they are literally tied.
But that's okay, because it's not going to last very long.
Yeah, it won't last that long. This intro is probably just building your ratio, just getting yourself warmed up first.
And even giving you an opportunity to climb.
Oh, that's an early 200 for Kibitz, actually.
Oh, here we go.
My advantage to ZYuan. ZYuan actually drops quite a bit from this LN section here by 0.1%. Now Kibitz has the lead.
Yeah. And it looks like it's only growing as Juan's just picking up a couple more 200s.
Oh, but it's the first miss of
Kibitz at the start.
Oh, but Kibitz has missed.
Kibitz approaching ZYuan's accuracy by 0.01 now, and ZYuan actually falls below that, getting a 200. But Kibitz as well gets a 200.
Yeah, no, they're both very similar in accuracy.
Oh, ZYuan picks up a 50!
Okay, ZYuan did pick up a 50, but he did not pick up a combo break. Has that combo break?
Very lucky.
Alive, just as ever.
Oh, but suddenly the accuracy has flipped. Kibitz has the accuracy lead.
That is exactly what he is doing.
Approach the hardest part of this map right now.
They're both tight in accuracy. Ziyan kind of falls off a bit.
One crossing.
There's a miss on Ziyan! Yeah, it's gonna flip! It's gonna flip the Kibitz!
It's flipped, it has flipped.
It's fighting for every opportunity because he knows if he slips up, he may very well lose that lead.
And we're approaching probably the last half a minute of the map. 0.1% accuracy advantage, the combo advantage as well. He picks up a few 200s, but same as ZYuan actually picks up a few 200s as well.
He's doing what Juan couldn't, and that's crossing 3000. And he actually has the better accuracy. So it looks like Fitz, provided that he doesn't miss this ending, should take this down. What a victory. And he's done it.
He's done it.
Please. Please. Come on. This is my heart right now, dude. I'm fucking beating. Did I win? Please. Let's go!
I wanna die.
Yes! We won! Let's fucking go! Oh my god! We fucking won!
And now, GG to Kibitz advancing in the winner's bracket.
To say this match was close again would be such an understatement. This was the most intense match I have ever played. And big shoutouts to ZYuan for being such a good sport and putting on such a good show. Boys, we're in the finals. With a confirmed podium spot secured, my next opponent was xRay, a legend in the Osimania Malaysian community. He strives on his insane ratio on any map he plays, as well as his ability to read such dense patterns. Now, this is the final stage, meaning the map pool was way harder than any previously.
Semi-finals, they both won the tiebreakers. And now they're here. And the winner's finals.
Ooh. Udo just got his COVID vaccine today.
Oh.
He's now immune from COVID.
Yeah. My left arm was in a lot of pain, and I was hoping to end the match as soon as possible. Getting on with the rolls, I won, and once again chose to pick first and ban second. Now ZYuan and xRay's playstyle were very similar, so I was expecting an SV ban, allowing me to ban one of the LM maps which I know for a fact Ray can outratio me. But he did this.
Alright, I'm gonna predict he's gonna ban SV 102. What? He banned Rice 5? What's Rice? Fuck! Fuck! Man! Shit! Oh my god, that changes everything! No!
With him banning the Courtjack map, which was my best performing map, I was forced into banning SV, leaving LN1 open for the taking. I still won my role, however, so I get to choose first, and I proceeded with Rice 6.
Huh? What?
Rice 6. Oh, oh wait.
It looks like he has a man gate on. I think this is real.
Oh no, that is.
Oh my god, what is happening?
He needs pick, right?
This is his. Wait, no.
Oh, he has missed again.
Is he all he has to do now is just combo, actually. There's no way Kibitz can come back. My accuracy alone.
Oh, the hit drop along with the miss. No, Kibitz has the advantage.
Yes, but Kibitz missed twice. He'll need X-ray to drop a bit more for him to catch it back up.
Kibitz now has to lead. Yeah. I don't think it's gonna happen. Kibitz is gonna take away his first point. Almost a break point, actually. That was close.
Yeah, I definitely lost this one. Fuck! How did I miss at the beginning? I'm fucking trash. Oh! Oh! Eh? Huh? Eh? Huh? Let's go! Let's go! Wow!
That was too close for comfort. But Ray responded back instantly with an LN hybrid pick.
A miss would just swing it immediately. Kibitz fighting hard, holding that lead, but
Ray's catching up. Hopefully handling the jack really well, and now we're onto a second key eye.
His burst. The Nell is trying to it, both players still full comboing the map.
Please, let that be enough. Please, Jesus. Yatta! Yes! Let's go! First breakpoint. Nice. Yosh! I turn Japanese when I'm try hard.
Somehow winning that pick, I was really surprised on how I was doing considering my arm condition. At that point, I decided to continue avoiding long nodes and stick with the accuracy-based rice maps.
The technical map is really like, it's really arm heavy, arm muscle heavy, and my, I don't know, my left arm is not feeling well. I'll do it though, rice 4.
Here comes the very stupid part.
Yep. Very stupid.
It's space. Yeah, but you can't even stream. Can you stream?
The stream, will they hold?
They held. And here comes the last spooky part. Kibitz dropping some 200s.
Yeah, and so does X-ray. Ray. Yeah.
And Ray.
I hope my combo was enough. Okay. Okay. Oh, that was my highest combo I've ever had before. Okay. Whew.
One thing I didn't consider at the time was how jack-heavy that tech map was, especially on my left arm. But trying to ignore the pain, Ray went with Longnet 1, the map I was most worried about.
I forgot to take off my tab key. Thank God I didn't alt-tab. Okay. So far, alright. Now he's going to the LN. Okay. Alright, I see. He's busting out the LN.
Actually, now Kibitz has the lead.
Yeah, Ray dropped a bunch of 200s all of a sudden. Now Kibitz has the lead, as you said.
Still, the gap is still too close to make conclusions.
There's still so much more of the map to go.
One 200 can change the table and make some extra.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Missed, and his accuracy is so much better.
On such a hard long note release timing map, I had a 4-0 lead, but here's where I was stuck between two options.
Do I risk it and go for the SV? I'll be throwing if I choose SV, because I've never full combo. He's probably going to choose LN2 or LN3 next. I know that for a fact. Hybrid 2 is so stamina draining, it's 5 minutes long. So either SV1 or Hybrid 2. I'm not picking these three. That's too risky. Let's go. SV1.
Ray has to get to the combo cap.
But Kibitz misses.
Oh, that makes X-Ray jump easier.
X-Ray just needs to hold the combo a little bit longer. If he can break anywhere, will he be able to do it? And that's it. X-Ray.
Finally, his first point.
Yeah, and being a breakpoint. Wow.
Looking back on this pick, I really should have thought it through better. I knew for a fact I had such a massive mind block on that whole section, but I decided to go with it anyway. With a point under Ray's belt, he started to play for real now. And he chose LN3, the full long note map. Yep, I'm fucked.
Alright, I'm guessing he's gonna choose LN 2 or 3. LN 2 or 3. He's not gonna pick hybrid. Yeah, he's okay. Full long note, okay. Time to throw it again.
Kibitz. Now stabilize. Accuracy now maintained from 1%, slowly climbing back. Actually, very comfortable with a 99.5%.
That's the end. And that's all the hard parts. We're approaching the end of the map.
Please. Please tell me you missed. He did not miss. Oh my fucking god. Jesus, that is better than my PB. Holy fuck. What do I do? I really don't want to risk these three. I think... Oh, this is so risky. I have no good picks. Oh. Let's go hybrid two.
Here comes the second QA. He will drop a couple of 200s there. Now xRay has the accuracy advantage.
Kibitz still has the FC, and that's giving him the lead now, but this lead is so small.
No!
I'm sorry, the miss!
All thing is missing!
And that's good, now xRay, all you need to do is to maintain the accuracy. He doesn't have the burden of the combo.
Yes, exactly.
It's your last KI. xRay has to hold the accuracy in order to get this.
To decide everything.
This was a mix just got coughing.
Yes, that's just gonna seal it.
Is that it?
Extra
point, yeah. And no.
Wow.
We went from almost a clean sweep to a perfect to an almost tie.
Instead of tiring him out, I was definitely feeling the burn on my left arm right now. There were four maps left. Rice 1, 2, 3, oh my god, he went with LN2.
Kibitz, his hit air is all over the place, now dropping below 99.5.
xRay has to maintain the accuracy, and Kibitz has to do something about his ratio. He gets it! xRay with a 4.4 to 4 tie. We went from 4-0 to 4-4.
Here we are. 4 points each. 3 maps left to choose, and all of them being rice maps. This was the exact same scenario I was in against ZYuan. So, what did I do? Well, I went with the same strat that I used against ZYuan and lost. But maybe this time I'll do better?
That's gonna change things.
Yes. You don't. You have to focus here.
It's fucking.
Kibitz. Now he's slow dropping accuracy. Slow this X-ray though, and now we have this
fight. Oh, the X-ray giving me miss.
Will that seal the deal? Will Kibitz hold?
Will Kibitz do it? Miss will shift this, but he full combos the map. And wow.
Wow, okay.
Please! That's my first full combo! Yes! Yes! Okay. Tiebreaker. Confirmed. Okay. Match point. My heart is beating so fast! I need to wash my hands. My legs, I can't feel them.
By the skin of my teeth, I secured match point, but that leaves Ray picking between rice 1 and 2. The match had been going on for 45 minutes up to this point, and my left arm was in so much pain. With rice 1 being the decider, I knew tiebreaker was inevitable.
My legs are still shaking. Rice 1, no, it's gonna come down to tiebreaker. I have never played through this map. You can see I don't have a score on this. I have never played this map. Oh my god.
Kibitz is doing a really good job as well, because he's still high up there. So if xRay is not gonna miss, it wouldn't matter.
xRay misses again.
No.
The lead goes back to Kibitz.
Oh, I should shut up.
We have less than 1/3 of the map remaining. This is a chance he has to hold. He cannot miss anymore.
Yes, he needs to hold.
With another miss, making xRay's job easier. But we still have one more handstream part remaining. The player stamina is now draining to the end. Kibitz is missing a punch.
Oh,
I'm so tired.
But
it won't matter. xRay.
xRay attacking. His first point bringing into tiebreaker.
At this point, I was out of juice. I was so tired. I had no energy left to play. I did not want to continue playing at all. But I was there to put on a good show, not to complain about my arm hurting, so with the little amount of energy I had left, I gave it my all to the second tiebreaker in a row.
Going into it, the tiebreaker between Kibitz and xRay. Stop here. And I'm going into it.
Kibitz
immediate miss. But so does xRay. Accuracy in full, the accuracy tanks quite a bit. Hopefully, it will hit those bursts. Kibitz rapidly climbing his accuracy, trying to match Ray.
Here comes the last part. It was with more misses, and oh, that is gonna hurt even more to Kibitz.
Yes, this is gonna wind and get, but Kibitz gets another miss with some accuracy drops as well.
He has lost the stamina, but will actually start missing. Yes, but that doesn't matter right now. xRay just has the superior accuracy loop. Kibitz misses even more.
My hand, it hurts so much.
Now this last part remaining, Kibitz getting yet another drop.
I mean that's a... At least with a 30 score lead, xRay is going to take it. Confirm top 2.
GG. He won. Yeah.
GG to xRay.
GG. Kibitz doing really well as also. He just struggled a lot at the ending there, and that gave xRay the win.
Losing that match with a 4-0 lead. That really sucked. knowing very well that I could have taken the win under different conditions. But I'm not completely out of the tournament yet, as I head down to the loser's bracket, so I'm quite hopeful. What the fuck, man? For those who don't know who Neo is, well, at the time of recording this, he's actually global rank number 21. Which is the number one player in Malaysia. As well as with a brand new map pool made just for grand finals, yeah, I could not full combo anything to save my life. But the show must go on, so here we go.
Yep, I knew he was gonna ban his V1. Doesn't matter what I ban, bro. He fucking can FC everything. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe, catch it, baby. What? No. Okay. Rice 3.
Is this Kibitz pick?
Yes, this is Kibitz pick.
This is Kibitz pick.
Yeah, all this.
And Neo will take it by the skin of their teeth.
First break point already, leading by 20k.
Yeah, Leon, your theory is working out again about Neo's consistency. And Kibitz being overall better, but those misses just hurt so much overall.
But Kibitz missing more and more and more. It seems like he's
having a 99% as well.
Oh, this split shows he must be very tight right now.
Gosh, Neo has like infinite stamina. What the hell is going on?
It's Neo.
Is this like a 990?
More than that.
Barely, oh my god. They're just almost shy, almost. But there you go, an FC 13-200. Neo got lesser. Neo got lesser 200s than Kibitz has misses. That is stupid.
Oh my gosh.
This is grand final. You're not supposed to do this.
Well, with those first two picks, I was pretty damn sure I wasn't winning this. But could I prevent a clean sweep? Who knows? Maybe I should wash my hands.
Oh boy. Kibitz is hard stuck on 99.8, not anymore. Drops down to 99.75 and Neo has a very small advantage.
That's okay because we have still have 50% of the map remaining. Kibitz still has the time to bring this all back. We still have not gotten the accuracy advantage back.
Hold that thought.
Drop a 200. Now they're tight.
This is Kibitz's point to lose now.
Accuracy drop from Neo.
Yeah, Neo just rushed the pattern for like a split second, and Kibitz is in the driving seat. There's about, I'll say, half a minute left. Maybe lesser than
the
that.
The last section is very chokeable. More jumpy.
Kibitz cannot drop combo. This is still within striking distance. Neo hasn't dropped that far off. Fuck yes!
Wow, both players full comboing that.
Oh my god!
Easy.
that ratio difference of 1-300, but Neo rushing two patterns, getting a couple of hundreds as well, so
there you really go. Identical ratio, yeah.
Wow.
No clean sweep today, baby. Anyways, you can expect what happens after this.
Mora has a whole 50k point lead?
Yeah, around there.
Yeah, wow. Almost 50,000.
Wow. Oof.
It's a combo.
Yes. Davis is doing a great job holding the combo, but if he keeps getting 200 drops, it won't matter. As I said, at wow, that is a very nasty drop. Accuracy drop by Kibitz. Now I'm down to
97.5.
And only to a miss.
It will take another FC 12 200s.
And wow.
What kind of. What?
Okay, Neo.
But will it happen though? Kibitz drops a miss himself, and I think that should be it.
Yeah, that seals the deal.
Oh, 96!
Oh my god!
How many 200s is that? What?!
Five!
It's an egg?
Yeah.
It's not going to be enough to nick a point off Neo, and Neo will take a 6 point. And they are 1 point away from facing xRay.
Neo, now at match point.
By the way, once again, another FC from Neo.
Oh, what a surprise!
What a surprise!
Here it was. Match point to Neo, and with me just tagging along as the punching bag. I knew this last pick would be the last map I ever play in this tournament, and I'm so glad that Neo chose this.
There's always the chance that Kibitz does a reverse sweep. Oh, but Neo's going for SB2!
That is... What a bad pick for a match point!
Neo has the experience playing this map before. Kibitz saying to finish him off in style.
I'm not sure about playing because I've never played it. I bet I it's played. Oh, what?! Both players going hidden!
You bet your ass I'm gonna lose in style.
For Neo to win this yet.
And Neo didn't mess up the build up this time.
Alright, now we are chasing.
This teleport.
Kibitz is hitting quite early. So is Neo, but Kibitz is hitting early more. Oh, actually, hold on.
And we have this, oh my gosh.
Oh, now Neo is hitting a lot earlier than Kibitz. Kibitz is still trying to hold onto their combo as much as they can. They're dropping a lot of hundreds. They're hitting extremely early, but Neo drops the miss as well. Kibitz is just falling off the face of this match now. 94, below 94.
Yeah, he lost control.
Both players dropping at the same time. Neo just hanging on to 95. But this should just be it, and this should seal the deal.
Yeah, this should definitely seal it.
And ladies and gentlemen, your finalists, your top two, Neokje will go against xRay tomorrow, and Kibitz will finish in third. That was overall a pretty intense match though.
That was something.
And that's pretty much it. I finished third overall in the first iteration of the Malaysian Mania tournament. Neo actually went on to defeat Ray through a bracket reset, which was expected, to be honest. Big congrats to him and Ray for achieving second and first. Another big shout out to Cryo and Unicow for hosting this tournament in general and allowing me to play competitive Osu Mania again. And if you made it this far into the video, I appreciate you so much for sticking around for this long, and hopefully I gave you a bit of insight and maybe even motivation to play in tournaments. But all I can say now is hope you enjoyed watching, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. Come over to the Twitch channel too, to watch these plays happen live, and trust me, watching it live is just a whole different experience. And that's pretty much it. Thank you. See you.